Hello children, I am Prasanna. In this video I am going to explain classification of triangles. In my last video I have explained what is triangle, what are the sides, angles and vertices of a triangle, that you can see in my previous video. So in this we are going to discuss about the classification or types of triangles. So we are having classification of triangles on the basis of sides and angles. Okay, on the basis of sides we are having three types of triangles, and on the basis of angles we are having three types of triangles. Okay, now we are going to discuss one by one. First, on the basis of sides we are going to discuss. Okay children, so here triangles, so on the basis of sides and angles. So on the basis of sides, first one we are going to discuss about, here we are taking only sides. First one is equilateral triangle. Equi means what? Equal. Lateral means what? Sides. So equilateral sides means a triangle in which all the three sides, here we are considering sides children, a triangle in which all the three sides are equal, then we can say the triangle as equilateral triangle. Coming to the definition, a triangle having all the three sides of equal length. So example, here is a triangle, it's a closed figure formed by three line segments. Suppose this is A, this is B, this is C. So sides are nothing but AB, BC, AC. So of equal length. Example, I am taking 3 cm. Suppose AB 3 cm, AC 3 cm, BC 3 cm. So here if you consider AB, BC, CA are of equal length. So this type of triangle is known as equilateral, an equilateral triangle. Right? So you can write like this also children. Suppose this is triangle X, Y, Z. So this side and this side and this side are equal. So here it is, we can write XY, the side XY is equal to side YZ is equal to side ZX. So XY is equal to YZ equals to ZX. So if the three sides of a triangle are equal, then we call it an equilateral triangle. So on the basis of sides, first we discuss equilateral triangle. So coming to second one, isosceles triangle. So a triangle in which all the three sides equal is nothing but equilateral triangle. Now coming to isosceles triangle children, a triangle in which two sides are equal, actually triangle will have three sides, in which two sides are equal, then we can say that triangle as isosceles triangle. So coming to definition, a triangle having two sides of equal length. So example, here A, B, C. Here this is 4 cm. If it is 3 cm, 3 cm. So in this, out of 3 sides, we are having AB and AC as equal length, 3 cm. And BC is different. So here in this, 2 sides are equal. Then we call this type of triangle as isosceles triangle. Here in general you can write, suppose X, Y, Z. So any two sides children, it is not compulsory only these two. If I take this and this, here these two sides are equal and this is not equal. So here in this, XY is equal to YZ. right? XY is equal to YZ. So here two sides are equal, then we call it as isosceles triangle. Triangle having two sides of equal length. Next, the third one is scalene triangle. So a triangle in which three sides are equal is equilateral triangle. A triangle in which two sides are equal is isosceles triangle. Coming to scalene triangle, and triangle in which no sides are equal means all the three sides are unequal length, having unequal length, right? So coming to definition, a triangle having all the three sides are unequal, are unequal length. Okay, so here coming to shape, suppose this is 4 centimeters, this is 3 centimeters, this is 2 centimeters. A, B, C. Here AB is not equal to BC and BC is not equal to AC, means all the three sides are of different length. So this type of triangle is called scalene triangle. So in general, we can write like this. X, Y, Z. Here in this figure, XY is not equal here, this two and not equal. So XY is not equal to YZ. And YZ is not equal to ZX. Means all the three sides are having different length. So this type of triangle is called scalene triangle. So we are having three types of triangles based on sides to length. One is equilateral triangle, second is isosceles triangle, and third is scalene triangle. And it's very easy to remember also, children. In equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal. In isosceles triangle, only two sides are equal. In scalene triangle, no sides are equal. Next, we are going to discuss triangles based on angles. So, on the based on angles also, angles, triangles are again of three types. Okay. So, in that first one is acute angled triangle. So, based on angles here, not sides. Okay. So, first one is acute angled triangle. So, you know the sum of the three angles in a triangle is how much, children? 180 degrees. When you add the three angles of a triangle, it should be 180 degrees, right? So, based on angles we are discussing here. So, the sum of the three angles should be always 180. It should not be less than 180. It should not be greater than 180. Exactly equal to 180. Here, a triangle is having how many angles? Three angles. So, in this acute angle triangle, all the three angles should be acute. Means all the three angles should be less than 90. Now you know what is acute angle. So an angle whose measure lies between 0 to 90. Means greater than 0 and less than 90. So in this all the three angles should be acute. Then we call it as acute angled triangle. So come definition. A triangle whose all angles are acute. Right? Example. I'm considering triangle. Here we are considering angles. Okay? So we can take any, suppose this is 50, 70 and this is 60. If you see, 50 is acute angle, 70 is acute angle, 60 is also acute angle. So when you add 50 plus 70 plus 60, so you should get 180. Right? So if all the three angles are acute, then we call it as acute angled triangle. So you can take another example also, children. So So 80 plus 60 plus 40 gives you 180. So example here 40, 80 and 60 are three acute angles. So a triangle in which all the three angles are acute, then we call it as acute angled triangle. Coming to second type is obtuse angled triangle. You know what is obtuse angle, children? Angle whose measure lies between 90 and 180. Means it should be greater than 90 and less than 180. So here the definition of this is a triangle in which one angle is obtuse. So a triangle whose one angle is obtuse. Why I am asking here saying only one angle? A triangle can have three acute angles, but a triangle cannot have more than one obtuse. Because here obtuse means greater than 90, right? So you should, if I take, suppose smallest obtuse angle is 91. Okay? And 91 when I add, here you are going to get 182. That is, it is exceeding 180. But one more angle should be taken for triangle, because a triangle will have three angles. So if I take two obtuse angles, when I add two angles itself, it is exceeding 180 degrees. So we can't take two obtuse angles. So triangle will have only one obtuse angle. We cannot take two obtuse angles. But a triangle can have three acute. Okay. So definition of this is a triangle whose one angle is obtuse. If one angle is obtuse, then we call it as an obtuse angled triangle. So example, you know the shape of the obtuse angle, children. This is the shape of obtuse angle, right? If I draw this triangle, suppose it is 110 degrees. Okay. Next, if it is 40, it is 30. So 110 plus 40 plus 30 gives you 180. Okay. So you should take up to your shape, you know what is the shape of this. Okay. 130. Okay. 20 and 30. How much? 130 plus 20, 150. 150 plus 30 gives you 180. So if the one angle is obtuse, then we call it as obtuse angled triangle. Next, coming to third one, right angled triangle. So what is right here? Right angle means, you know, the value of the right angle is 90 degrees, right? So you can say now easily, a triangle whose one angle is 90 degrees, then we call it as a right angle triangle, right? So definition is a triangle whose one angle is right angle. So can I take two right angles, children, here? Yes, we can take 90 plus 90 equal to 180. Is that correct? No, because triangle will have three angles. When I add two angles itself, you are getting 180. Then what about this third angle? So we cannot take two right angles for a triangle. So only one angle. So we can take three acute angles. We can take only one obtuse angle. Here only one right angle. We cannot take two obtuse angles, two right angles in triangles. Okay. So definition is a triangle whose one angle is a right angle. And you know the shape of a right angle. This is 90 degrees. Yes. Now if I draw, this is a closer figure, formed a triangle. Right. A, B, C. So what about other two? It may be two acute. So 90 plus 40 plus 50 gives you 180. Okay, children. Right. So 90 plus 40 plus 50 and 30, 60. So 90 plus 30 plus 60 gives you 180. So if one angle is 90 degrees, we can say it is a right angle. And coming to another point, important point is the side opposite to 90 degrees. Here which is the side opposite to 90 degrees here? This is 90. Opposite to 90 degrees is what? AC. And this is called hypotenuse. Here the side opposite to 90 degrees. This is hypotenuse. And this is the longest side in right angle triangle. So if you compare this, this and this, hypotenuse will be the longest side. So very important point, the side opposite to right angle is called hypotenuse, and hypotenuse is the longest side in right angle triangle. Now I'll draw roughly a flowchart for the classification of triangle children. Suppose this is triangles. So triangles are divided into six types, means three types on basis of based on sides and based on angles. Okay, so based on size, here we are having three types of triangle. So one is equilateral triangle, second is isosceles triangle, third one is scalene triangle. So coming to equilateral triangle, a triangle in which all the three sides are equal. Now scalene is a triangle in which two sides are equal. Scalene is a triangle in which no sides are equal. So if all the three sides are equal, it is an equilateral triangle. If two sides are equal, it is isosceles triangle. If no sides are equal, it is scalene triangle. Next one, based on angles, again it is divided into three types. So in that, first one is acute angled triangle, and next one is obtuse angled triangle, and last one is right angled triangle. Coming to acute angled triangle, a triangle in which all the three angles are acute. If I take 60, 50, 70. 50, 60, 70 are three acute angles. So a triangle having three angles acute is called acute angled triangle. Coming to obtuse, the shape will be like this. Okay. You can take 120, 40 and 20. So here 40 and 20 are acute and 120 is obtuse. So a triangle in which one angle is obtuse, then we call it as obtuse angled triangle. Next, coming to right angle triangle, a triangle in which one angle is 90 degrees. You can take 45 also. If you observe, 45 and 45 are acute and 90 is right angle. So a triangle having one angle 90 degrees means one angle right angle, then we call it as right angled triangle. And the side opposite to right angle is nothing but hypotenuse, and hypotenuse is the longest side in right angled triangle.